pass down the sideline is going to be picked off by Brandon Carr.
As he arrived in Allendale 15 years ago to play football at Grand Valley, Brandon Carr was so quiet he might have been invisible if not for his obvious athletic ability. Brandon started on two national championship teams before being drafted into the NFL, where he resides today in Baltimore, having embarked upon his 12th pro season. But he was back in Allendale in both June and July, once for the opening of the new Hosford Football Center, the other time for a team event sponsored by the Carr Cares Foundation. And while the competition that week gave him the undivided attention of its players, the message from the 2019 NFL Man of the Year nominee was that to whom much is given, much is expected.
A lot of guys come before y'all that work pretty hard, man, unselfishly. For the team, but for the future as well.
I've been blessed to play this game for going into year 12 and years before then. Met a lot of amazing people, but I've also had a lot of influencers who have impacted my life for the better. And, you know, I just feel like it's only right that once I get my opportunity to play this game at the biggest level that there is, why not reach back and help my community as well? And that's where the foundation came into play.
When Carr and prep teammate Dan Scuda came to Grand Valley from Flint's Carmen Ainsworth High School, no one had any idea the two would combine for over 20 years in the NFL. And it would have been just as impossible to predict Brandon would use his pro football success to become a leading proponent for child literacy in all the places he's lived. He's been honored and lauded by civic groups and communities and is likely to make his foundation work a full-time occupation when his playing days end.
Whether it's white, black, rich or poor, kids need help, kids need resources. They need to be literate and proficient readers. And that's what the foundation does, is providing that extra resource, and motivation, encouragement to get these kids in the right direction.
In high school, when he first got on the recruiting radar of Grand Valley, it seemed to both parties Brandon Carr was destined for Division I. But since his success in Allendale and then in the pros, no one seemed surprised about what Carr became and what he might yet accomplish.
What Brandon Carr doesn't get enough credit for is here's a guy that he doesn't need to be here. He's successful both on the field and financially secure, but he recognizes where he came from.
How many guys do you see walk in his locker room and get cut from it? You know, and his preparation and his professionalism and his being a team guy, you know. I know Coach Harbaugh at the Raven, like, Coach Harbaugh loves Brandon Carr. Loves him for preparation, loves him because he's a great player, but loves him because who he is.
With 176 consecutive starts in the NFL prior to the 2019 season, it's fair to say Brandon Carr has exceeded all expectations anyone might have had for him. But even when his football days eventually end, his determination and drive will still be on display for the youth of America to see.
I always feel like I can never do enough, you know, once I go to, whether I'm going to a school to read, do a play 60, have a football camp, or have a weekend at home. It's always, you know, what can we do next? So how can we make this bigger? How can we impact more lives and, you know, be more effective with our coverage?
In the NFL, Brandon Carr has written the book on how to stay healthy and play at an impossibly high level for a long time. Off the field, his young fans will be reading books for a long time after their hero hangs up his cleats. For the Grand Valley State Sports Report, I'm Tom Cleary.